I wouldn't go in there.
I'm just going to turn around because,
yeah,
like...
Yeah, you go like in the dirtiest...
We were talking on the thing, and
I'm
who can help, rather than making video.
My God, we just wait for a signpost, and you're just like getting stressed out.
I'm not getting stressed out. I'm saying I'd rather just ask someone who's
you can't cross
help,
it, and you can't, like you're on the left side now. You're gonna ask some guys that we don't even know, so
was gonna go to the petrol station actually, is that
so,
alright?
And you drive on the left side?
I'm turning round, is it okay if I cross the road?
Okay, yeah. We are already lost in Detroit. We left the city centre and we're like in a neighborhood where everything is closed and you have abandoned house and buildings. So we found our hotel in Detroit Airport, which is called Columbus.
Romulus,
that's the actual town. So it's actually far from the city center, so yeah. And so we went to an Italian restaurant, and it's classic American with booth and everything. So yeah, we can see the difference in culture between Canada and America, that's for sure. Salad came pretty quickly. French sauce, which is not vinaigrette. How's that French? Welcome to America.
Wow.
Bon appétit.
Portion
here are massive. Actually massive.
I don't know if this is enough for me though, because...
And we had a salad.
I'm a growing girl.
Trees of green, red roses too, I see them blue.
You have literally no one walking in the street. We don't see, I think we like, if we can see like 10 people walking, yeah, that'd be lucky. So yeah, we're just a bit outside of the downtown now, and some people, and a beer. Literally like the most people we've seen in the last 10 minutes.
What a wonderful world.
Zoe, nice meeting you,
Sandra. Yeah, nice to meet you.
Nice to have an opportunity to share with you some of the other side of Detroit, some of the other side of the state of Michigan. We have interacted with, Europeans. It's kind of a cool thing for us because we don't get a chance to see you guys that much, and we just thought our neighborhood is all there is. But when you get out and meet people like Sam and Zoe, then we find out there's a much bigger world than we thought it was. That was just
it was
a cool
nice
thing.
It was very nice to meet you, Josh.
Cool thing.
Cheers.
Have a good day.
So nice
thank
you. Sam, Zoe. See you guys when I see you.
See
right?
ya. Bye.
All right.
Have a good one.
Yep. Same you guys.
Bye. So we just met George when we are looking at the statue. And he came to talk to us, and we exchanged about like Detroit life and everything. So that was pretty cool. He was very open-minded, and he was talking about the U.S. situation and Detroit situation, and yeah, it was really enjoyable.
What a wonderful world.
What's your impression?
It's got a lot of homeless people. a lot of poverty. But then, yeah, you've got the centre, which is looks quite affluent, I guess, like a normal city. But yeah, it's a bit sad to see like so many people that are like homeless and stuff. Yeah.
Even in downtown, in the center, you can see some massive building that seems empty and ready to be leased. Yeah. So yeah, now we've been walking around North Detroit, and it's quite special. Like you have like abandoned house, and so that's just one. There's plenty of them, and you have also like normal houses where people are actually living. No sign of transportation, and it's quite mad to see that. The last thing that I probably mentioned before, I'm not sure, is that Detroit had like almost 2 million people living there, and now there's 700,000. So it tells you that everything is being made for to be a big city, but it feels very, very empty, basically. Very, very empty. So, well, yeah, that's one part of Detroit that has to be seen, I guess. It can't be always about like the nice part of town. And yeah, so that's our impression, I guess. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.